victims of Jeffrey Epstein filed charges Wednesday, accusing the FBI of covering up its failure to probe the late financier, enabling his sex trafficking to continue for over 20 years. The victim said the FBI received credible tips of his trafficking as early as 1996, but they failed to interview victims or share information with federal and local law enforcement. The FBI began the probe in 2006, but ended 2 years later after Epstein pleaded guilty to a Florida prostitution charge. The victims added the FBI kept ignoring tips until his July 2019 arrest. Epstein committed suicide a month later. The number of Epstein's victims is believed to be at over 100. Tragedy struck the Super Bowl celebrations in Kansas City. At least one person was killed, while up to 15 more were hurt in a shooting incident near the victory parade of the Kansas City Chiefs. Several children were among those injured, while three people are in critical condition. Two suspects were taken into custody. The gunfire sent terrified fans running for cover, marring yet another high-profile event in the U.S. with gun violence.
We didn't know what was happening, but this day and age, when people run, you run. And so I put my arms around her and we tried to push through so people wouldn't run on top of us. And there was a woman crying, saying something about somebody had been shot. Of course, it's hard to know, is it a singular incident or is there an active shooter? But we got pushed all the way up to Union Station. So we ran into a hallway and a janitor said, come into this area. We went where an elevator was. We shut the doors and sat back against the doors. And we prayed and we went through a side door and there were officers. I've never been so glad to see an officer in my life.
Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news-making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with U.S. politics. Donald Trump may be riding high from his recent caucus victories as he gets closer to bagging the Republican nomination. But will he win his case before the Supreme Court?
Legal experts say Donald Trump may soon get more good news, this time from the U.S. Supreme Court. The High Court last week held oral arguments in keeping the erstwhile leader from the 2024 ballot due to his involvement in the January 6th attack on the U.S. Capitol. Prominent Filipino-American lawyer George Conway, together with members of his new organization, the Society for the Rule of Law Institute, weighed in on the case.
This seems to be where the consensus was, where they're going to say that in the case of the president, states cannot make the determination that the president or the presidential candidate is disqualified. It's going to be, I think, a very, very narrow decision, but it could command 7, 8, or 9 votes, perhaps.
Conway says the justices, some of which are Trump appointees, would likely find a way to rule for the former president without highlighting his role in the Capitol riots. While some expect the justices to favor Trump's arguments, the Supreme Court has not given a time frame on when the decision will be handed down.
We head to New York, where residents woke up to the heaviest snowfall in 2 years, and some took it as an opportunity to have some fun.
New York City was blanketed in white after a coastal storm dropped as much as 3.2 inches of snow on Tuesday, ending a snow drought in the Big Apple that lasted almost 2 years. While officials encouraged residents to stay indoors, some took it as an opportunity to have some fun at Central Park. These Filipinas who explored what became a winter wonderland said it can be tricky to navigate the streets of New York City.
Yung mga sidewalks, minsan you have to take extra precautions kasi nga very slippery and slushy.
Her biggest tip to pedestrians is to wear these.
Nakalagay yan pag bibili ka waterproof and it's the snowshoes.
But melting snow and standing water in area roadways may become icy as temperatures were expected to drop overnight, making the streets more treacherous for pedestrians.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
White House National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan warns all eyes are on a push for U.S. lawmakers to back a critically needed funding bill for Ukraine's war against Russia. Sullivan said among those to be funded by the bill are U.S. troops in the Middle East, forces protecting commerce in the Red Sea, and humanitarian aid in Gaza. He also laid responsibility for the bill's future entirely on House Speaker Mike Johnson.
Every day comes at a cost to the people of Ukraine and to the national security interests of the United States of America. The stakes are getting higher. The costs of inaction are also getting higher every day, especially in Ukraine. We've been increasingly getting reports of Ukrainian troops rationing or even running out of ammunition on the front lines as Russian forces continue to attack both on the ground and from the air, trying to wear down the Ukrainian air defenses that we've worked so extensively to build up over the past 2 years. So our allies are watching this closely. Our adversaries are watching this closely.
The bill, which also includes security funding for Israel and Taiwan, drew ire from Republicans, particularly those who are allied with former U.S. President Donald Trump. Families of Israeli hostages still held in Gaza pressing the International Criminal Court to take legal action against Hamas leaders. The complaint calls for the ICC to prosecute the Palestinian militant group for genocide, war crimes, and crimes against humanity over the October 7 attack. Israel believes more than 100 hostages remain in Gaza, with 29 believed to be dead.
The struggle against the murderous Hamas terror organization is not just a problem for the state of Israel, but the entire world. The world cannot stay silent. It is up to the world to intervene. It is up to other countries to impose sanctions and act against Hamas leaders.
Perpetrators should be held criminally accountable for the atrocity they committed. We trust that the ICC has the capacity to bring about justice for the hostages and their families.
The deadly October 7 rampage of Hamas sparked the months-long war in Gaza, killing over 28,000 Palestinians to date. Washington facing a serious national security threat from Russia. That warning coming from U.S. congressional leaders without providing further details on the matter. House Intelligence Committee Chairman Mike Turner earlier urged the White House to declassify information about the alleged threat related to Russia's nuclear weapons capability. U.S. House Speaker Mike Johnson confirms Turner's claims, but he assures the public there is no cause for alarm.
A meeting is now scheduled tomorrow on this matter here at the Capitol with the Gang of Four and with the President's National Security Advisor, Jake Sullivan. I will press the administration to take appropriate action, and everybody can be comforted by that. I want to assure the American people there is no need for public alarm. We are going to work together to address this matter, as we do all sensitive matters that are classified.
The allegations came amid an intense debate in Congress over how the U.S. should be dealing with global threats from Russia. Russian President Vladimir Putin weighing in on the U.S. elections. He says he prefers U.S. President Joe Biden over Donald Trump. For Putin, Biden is an old-school politician who is more experienced compared to Trump. He also described Biden as a predictable person. But Putin says he's willing to work with anyone who will win the election in November. Here's how the Kansas City Chiefs celebrated their Super Bowl victory. Quarterback Patrick Mahomes, tight end Travis Kelce, and head coach Andy Reid all spoke on stage and thanked the Chiefs Kingdom fan base for their support all season long. The Chiefs defeated the San Francisco 49ers 25-22 in a Sin City Super Bowl thriller on Sunday, cementing their status as an NFL dynasty. The Chiefs won their third Super Bowl in 5 years and became the NFL's first repeat champions since the New England Patriots in 2005.
Kansas City, let me hear you one time! Man, what a year to battle through the adversity, to continue to go. To go for that championship. They all doubted us. I don't want to hear any different. But you know who came through in the end. That's the Kansas City Chiefs.
How about the sea of red? Let's hear you, baby. I'm so proud of these guys behind me, the Hunt family, for giving us an opportunity to do this, for Brett Veach and his gang, for pulling all these great guys in here, man, and putting them together and them coming together as a team. Through all the highs and lows, they kept persevering, and now we're holding the trophy, and it belongs to the Red Sea right here, man. Congratulations.